All right, Shalom. I want to first start off giving all praises, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Makar Kadash. Double honor to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, and peace and blessings unto the elect of the nation of Israel. This is the brother Abadia from the GMS Houston camp, and I got a video to go into. The title of it is going to be called Get Your Shine On. There's a saying, well, not really a saying. You heard them, the rap group, the label or whatever, the Cash Money Records made the song Get Your Shine On. And all where there is a saying, especially I've heard it down south, but I don't know if they say it in other parts around this so-called country, but Jake liked to say, I'm shining. Not just necessarily shining because you got jewelry on, but if Jake is real good in a particular sport, you can, I've heard that, I've heard it in the sport world where they'll say, man, he's shining, man. Not because he has jewelry on, because he's playing ball well. Well, not well, but great. He having a great game, a hell of a game. Like, man, he out there shining. Okay? So it's also an expression used to show when somebody is really doing a hell of a job at something. Outside of, wearing this jewelry and all this stuff. Right? Now, us, we have the spiritual jewels, according to us being the ones that have the understanding of these scriptures, and that's according to Romans, the 11th chapter. And I'm gonna get that real quick. Let me get Romans 11. Let me get the verse 33, I believe. All right, this is Romans chapter 11 and verse 33. It says, oh, the depth of the riches, both of wisdom and knowledge of Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai. How unsearchable are his judgments and his ways past finding out. Okay, so the scriptures is letting us know that this wisdom, knowledge, and understanding is never-ending treasure. Okay, riches, true riches. All right, so we have this knowledge, we have the understanding, so we have spiritual riches, right? And with this wealth, okay, this money going into the if you go into the parable of I believe it's called the parable of the talents. Okay. We were given, all given a talent. The talent is representative of money. Certain amount of money that all the ones that were given a call to hear this word and get into it and become teachers, we all were given talents, money, right? And we were supposed to go out and exchange and grow the money or grow the business. Use the money, flip the money. Okay? And how do we do that? By going out on the highways and byways and putting up lessons on it. We're going out on the highways and byways and teaching. Okay? Putting up lessons, pushing this word out. Okay? The in transits. Or whatever, the walking talks. All right, pushing this word out that this knowledge, which is what the riches, may be planted in the minds of a hopeful elect member, and that individual comes into the fold of this knowledge, gets into it, and starts getting built up, and that process replicates itself. Okay, now you're making money with with the talent that you was given. Okay, so we were all given a certain amount of money of, you know, the scriptures, right? We got the scriptures. So we got the riches. And, you know, Jake do like to shine, meaning Jake, like, whatever Jake get into, he likes to be the top dog, right? Where we're given opportunity to really shine, but in this, more so, well, not more so, in the spirit of like a Barry Sanders. Okay, Barry Sanders was out there on the football field, and yeah, he was shining with his talent, right, with his skills, and but he was humble. He wasn't the type to showboat, get in the end zone, do a dance, talk shit to the opponents. You know, he wasn't flashy. He just went out there, did his thing amazingly, and was very humble about it, using him as a good example, a good analogy, you know. And that's how we should be. We got this wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. We should be shining, but with humility. You know what I'm saying? We should be showing forth skill, being skillful in this word. I believe if you go into that word app, when this, where the scripture, where Paul said, be apt to teach. I believe he was telling that to Timothy. I have to check. I'm not gonna get the scripture right now, but he said, the word app. I'm sorry, app. When you go into that word, it means skillful. Because you do have to be skilled in this word to use it, okay? To make the right investments and to flip the Lord's money, okay? You do have to be skillful. When you're teaching this word, you do have to be skillful. You got to know how to put precepts together, okay? Break down the prophecies, make it make sense, all right? Now I'm going to get a couple of scriptures. This is Matthew. Because I could, if I bring out all the scriptures that's running through my mind, we'll be here for a long time. I didn't intend for this lesson to be that long. I just want to push this out there that, you know, we've been given the ultimate riches, which gave us the skill to teach. Right, and we really can show forth skillful work, you know. So why not? This is Matthew chapter 5 and verse. And get straight to the point. 14 and 15. It says, "Ye are the light of the world," and this was Yahawashi speaking to the 12. It says, "You are the light of the world. A city that is set on an hill cannot be hid." Right. If there's a city with all the city lights on, and it's some way up there on top of a hill, you can't help but to see it. Okay. It says, "Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house." So we have that light to shine in a dark world, as the scriptures tell us in Isaiah 60, that the earth shall be covered in gross darkness. Okay, so we're living in a complete dark world, and we're shining. We have the ability to shine in this dark world. Okay, and we are shining. The light is going forth because the lessons are going out. The street speakings are going forth. Okay, and if you're not shining and you got this knowledge, then you know something's wrong with you. And I say that humbly. You know, we gotta go out there and put forth this shine forth this with this light. and shine and remain humble. Okay? Now, the scriptures tell us in St. John, the third chapter, starting around the 18th verse or the 19th verse, it says that this is the condemnation, that light is coming into the world, but men love darkness rather than light. So the vast majority, well, let's deal with Israel, because Israel scattered throughout the four corners of the earth, and they would rather be saturated in darkness versus come to the light. They have a love for darkness and they hate the light. And that's okay. We still got to go forth and shine, because it's going to come a point in time, as the scriptures say, that they're going to know that a prophet had been amongst them. Okay? And this last scripture, and bring this out, and I'm going to close out. Proverbs 4:18, it says, but the path of the just is as the shining light. Okay? The path of the just. So we hope to be of the elect, and we on the path to salvation, where that's our goal. We're going down this narrow path, right? The straight gate. And we're trying to make it to salvation. It says, excuse me. So I'm gonna read it again. It says, but the path of the just is as the shining light. Because as we're holding the light as we go down this path, right? We're shining down the path, creating a light way. It says that shineth more and more. Check that out. So as we go down this path, trying to receive salvation, we're supposed to be shining more and more. You see, it says unto the perfect day. What's the perfect day? The kingdom of heaven being established on this planet earth. And that's what salvation is all about, being saved and setting up, helping set up the kingdom. Right? So the scripture is telling us that we're supposed to shine more and more. So what does that mean? More work has to be put in. Okay? Being skillful in this word. I'm going to end it right there. Lord willing, this video was edifying. And to the next one, I say Shalom.